This is MMA Osprey.
Moving on to the next fight from UFC Fuel TV 6. It's a battle at welterweight between Paulo Thiago and Dong Young Kim. Guys, another competitive match at welterweight. I'm going to open up Kim as the favorite here. We're going to start off with Larry first. Larry, I'm going to open up Kim a 2-1 favorite. Minus 200, the comeback on Thiago is going to be plus 150. Give me your take and give me your bet.
Yeah, you know, I debated on this one, so I think you did a good job setting the line. But ultimately, I went with Stun Gun Kim. You know, when I really look at Paulo Thiago, he came out with that big win over Josh Koscheck, which was really like a flash knockout. He beat a declining Mike Swick at the time when Swick was having all his health problems. Then he beat Jacob Volkman, who has since gone down to lightweight where he belongs, and most recently beat David Mitchell. His losses are to Fitch, Campman, Diego Sanchez, and C.R. Bahadazera. I think those guys are more typical of Stun Gun Kim than the guys that Paulo has beaten. When I look at Stun Gun Kim in this fight, I think the big advantage he has is the advantage that he's won most of his fights with. He's huge for 170 pounds. He has a reach advantage. And Thiago has struggled with bigger, stronger guys like Fitch, like Campman. And I also question how Thiago is going to be coming off the first knockout to CR in his last fight. A lot of guys don't respond to that well. So I give Kim the slight edge because I think ultimately he'll be able to get in close, use his judo, and control the fight on the ground.
Okay, a lot of good points made from Larry here on Kim. He's going to lay the juice. It's going to be $1,000 to win $500. Let's throw it over to Damon Martin. Damon, what do you think about this one?
You know, everything Larry said is right, but, you know, obviously the line on this one's a little closer, and it is a pretty tough matchup. So I'm picking the upset and going with Paulo Thiago based purely on the fact that I think that, you know, he does have the submission skill to give Dong Young Kim some trouble. You know, both guys have had, you know, some rough fights lately. You know, Kim with his knockout to Condit and then the weird situation with Damian Maia. Paulo Thiago, obviously, I mean, he would look like he was going to be the great next welterweight contender, and then he's lost his three out of his last four. So this is really a must-win for both guys. I'm really picking with my gut more than my head in this one because, you know, logic says Dong Hyun Kim will go for takedowns and basically just stifle Thiago on the ground, kind of the way John Fitch did. But I just feel like Thiago on his feet has enough power to keep Kim away, and if he can defend his takedowns well enough and catch him in a submission or defend him well enough to keep it on the feet, I don't think Kim has the stand-up. But, you know, again, this is really a toss-up fight, but I'm going to go with the upset to say Paulo Thiago, just because I think he can do a little bit more on the ground, throw a few more submissions up, and probably win a decision.
Okay, so Damon is going to go with the dog value here at plus 150. It's going to be 500 to win 750 on Paulo Thiago in what should be an ultra-competitive fight at UFC on Fuel TV 6. Both of our experts split.
Well, that's it for another episode of MMA Odds Breakers. You can look for the odds that Nick broke right here on the show to start popping up at the sportbooks throughout the coming week. And a huge special thanks to our two guests, Larry Pepe and Damon Martin, as always, delivering the goods. Thanks, guys.
And make sure you guys check out our website, MMAOddsBreaker.com, if you haven't checked it out. We got a lot of cool gambling-related stuff, material content there for you guys to check out. Also, follow us on Twitter, at MMAOddsBreaker. For Miguel Odorati, I'm Nick Kalika saying until next time, enjoy the fights.